So I'm out here painting. I just did a workout out here in the hills, and so I fortunately had some stuff with me, and I can just get a painting worked on, or maybe a few. I just had I do have one canvas I'm working on, but it wasn't one I wanted to do out here. But I do have my multimedia tablet with me, so I'm gonna do some painting, do some practice. I have a commission piece that I am working on. It's really big, but I want to practice on the guy's face because I'm working on that right now. And doing portraits is a whole lot more interesting, or different than doing landscapes. So anyhow, I've just drew him out a while ago, and I am going to work on him. I've got my palette loaded with a few colors. Those are the colors I decided on for today. I'm out here on a rock. I did a bunch of hiking up and down. Running. Running straight up mountains. Cliffs everywhere up here, sand hills. I know you guys can't see it super well. But the terrain out here is perfect for doing rock climbing, working, jumping, push-ups, whatever sit-ups you want to do. So I've been doing those off and on out here, as well as across the way on those mountains over there. So it's been pretty fun being out here. There's a lot of straight-up hiking trails that I run up. No, I don't hike up them very often anymore because I've worked very hard to just be able to run up straight up things. And one of the ways I did that was just starting to do bleachers. I'll probably putting those in my running workouts and stuff. Oh, it's probably been like 3 years now when I was training with a few people for races and things like that, and helping train some younger girls. So anyhow, I'm just excited about today. Let's see if I could set this up anywhere. I didn't mean to bring something to set this on, but if I can set this up where you guys can see what I'm doing. And look at that. Pretty good, that process there. So let's turn that just a little bit more. And I hopefully do not get too cold for now. It seems like the sun's out a bit, and so I want to do a little bit of painting. Nothing major for now, but I thought I'd let you guys see how I start. And just having fun, having some stuff with me is the way I do it. So just having a little more. Today, some dirty brushes with me, but since I am not trying to sell these pieces, and this one is definitely practice because he's already on his way to being finished on a 5 foot by 4 foot piece that I've got him on, canvas that I've got him in. Anyhow, I just wanted to maybe use this piece that I had drawn out as practice earlier. So anyhow, you get to see how ridiculous my painting is. Not ridiculous, that's not the right way to put it. I tend to go completely out of the box when I paint, is I guess the way you put it. And I get some of the coolest paintings that way. And so often, I just start with what I have available. So, here we are, following some of these ideas. Just love painting this way, because for me, at times, it can be much more rewarding to not have a specific plan with colors or things like that. I like that too, and yes, I've been applying the colors to the one that's going to the gentleman the way I would like them to, but I like to come up with new stuff every time too that I paint. I want each of my pieces to be a masterpiece, and so if I'm not working on something new, and if I'm just following somebody else's rules, it doesn't really make any sense to me. I would say, even as a kid, I was the person that was just, I liked some ideas people had, but coloring out of the lines or doing my own thing, I did learn by doing some copying or brushstrokes and things like that when I was younger, but what's the way to put that? I only did, you know, when I was like 9 or so, I only did what I thought was interesting, the interesting parts of those paintings that other people did. And so that, you know, not everything interests me. That's how I have lived, I guess, in a way. Not I guess, definitely lived. So here I am. I get to see how my paintings get started a lot of times. You know, with oil paintings, there are so many layers, and I just start brush stroke at a time and not doing a lot of mixing of my own colors today, just because I'm out doing this for fun. Morning, since I'm already out here, and I know for a fact that once I worked out, I get cold fast, and so I can, when I get all sweaty and from working out, I can go paint for a while, but after a certain point, I start to freeze. And I hope there's some ducks over there. I don't know if you guys can see that. On the water, I hope you guys can. They decided to come over closer. They left earlier because I was just coming down here quick and wasn't being all that quiet. Ooh. Alright, let's see. We're going to make sure that I don't lose all the lines that I have. If I do that, then I will not see what the point of this drawing was about, which was drawing the person that it is. So anyways, drawing, painting, whatever. I draw with paintbrush most of the time. I don't often draw first. This time I did. I used a projector and I wanted to get like some just specifically seeing them. That I did a while ago. Like, I have been planning for this commission for a while and working on some other things, and I've been working on it for a bit, but it's also like I'm losing my train of thought apparently. It's also something that I wasn't focusing on right now because I was getting some other things done, so I am getting can with this piece at the moment. So I'm just gonna be quiet and paint for a little bit, pay attention to what I'm doing. enough brushes down here. Oh, here we go. Enough clean brushes down here to get some of the detail in that I would like to right at this moment. Let's just go for it. Or I could use some titanium white as well. But this is honestly why I like how I paint, because yes, there are times for having a plan in painting, but then there are times to just freaking go out there and paint. Just do it, you know. And so today is I have a few things with me, and I'm gonna do it. And that's it. And I tell you, I've got more fantastic paintings out of the just do it attitude that I've had my whole life than anything. It's maybe not for everyone, but my focus has always been get it done. If you want to do it, do it. And yeah, things take planning. Yes, things take training and work and all of that, and learning. But if you don't like get out there and do what you want to do, then you're gonna be spending all your time trying to figure out what you want to do instead of doing it. So maybe this painting's gonna look like a shit show for a little bit, but it'll be fantastic when I finish it. And today was a just do it moment, having my stuff out with me while I was I was working out. I had enough warm clothes to keep warm for a little bit, and had some time to do video, and that's where I'm at today. I think I'm gonna go ahead and stay off his face for a little bit because I don't have all the colors I need with me for this particular idea today. And I'm gonna put in some work right into here with some different colors. Getting my kids. Let's do that. I have been working on his portrait, so I do have some memory of what his face looks like, as also I know him in person, but I go with most portraits, at least I can't do them by memory, so I need a picture to really get the details down. And that's how I will watch. Can't remember where his jacket goes. I think it was out this way. Apparently I didn't put all the lines in I needed to. little cold out here for my paints to work without any mediums in it. And I didn't bring any in my car. I was, last time I was working, I was with the paints that are in my car. I was working up in the mountains in the evening. It was nice and warm out that day, a couple days ago. Anyway, so I definitely don't have everything I need, but I can get started. And that's what's so fun about painting is, like, you grab, you know, 4 colors and do a pretty awesome painting with those colors if you want to. And you can grab, you know, a multimedia pad like this. Pretty simple. You can get them from whatever hobby store you have near you. Or I don't even, Walmart has oil paints even. Which, years ago when I started, I had no money to spend on supplies, and so I just used the ducks are out there splashing around. I just used I use everything. I use anything and everything I get my hands on. I just needed to paint, and I built my own canvases, and I used Walmart oil paints until I found, actually, I don't think I went to Michael's for a while. I know I found some paints at Joann's. So anyhow, you want oil paint. The ones at Walmart, I mean, you don't want to, well, I mean, it's up to you. They're not, I don't know if they're archival quality sort of paints. I haven't really used them in a long time, but they're still fun to paint with and try. When you start using the better paints and the better tools, that's definitely nice too. But you don't have to use that crazy expensive of tools and mediums and all of that. And, you know, over the years I just added, this is before I decided to do it professionally, I just added, you know, learning about all of these things by doing it into my work. And when I say a multimedia pad, I think you guys probably see these often, like, around, and that's what they look like right there. Pretty simple. And these little easels you can get too, they're aluminum, they're super simple to use. I have a couple different kinds of easels, but this is like just, you can throw it in a backpack or just carry it in a bag or whatever you want to walk around with. And just go have fun. Be outside. I mean, obviously, what I'm doing right now is painting a portrait out in the wild. And I just like to be outside. Like, sometimes it has nothing to do with doing the landscape that's around me. I like looking at their landscape and doing landscapes too, but sometimes it's just about being outside and having my own peace and doing what I want to do with my artwork. And so I would love to encourage you all to just try, have fun. If you like to draw, get on draw. Just put that pencil to that paper, you know. There's no reason to not do that, except for you just didn't start. This friend and I were talking to this young girl one day in an art gallery. It was a great art gallery, and she was sitting there, and we were just talking to her, and she was maybe, I don't know, 20, And she's like, yeah, I want to take lessons and I want to paint. And she's got this little drawing book with her, and she just keeps it with her, but she never opens it and draws in it. And I think she had just gotten to the point where she was tired of doing that part of, you know, of drawing these tiny little drawings, and she needed to move up to upgrade. But you know, even just grabbing that little drawing book, or you know, starting to sketch and just seeing things, and taking 10 minutes a day to do that. If you want to do art, do it. It's so much fun. And if it's for pleasure, if it's for work, if it's you want to just start creating things, you want to sell at the farmer's market on Etsy, if you want to just do something for yourself that inspires you, that you've created something, I would just so encourage you to start doing that. I love it when I'm able to encourage other artists to move forward in doing things. You know, there's a lot of people that say they can't even draw a stick figure, so if that's how they feel, then maybe they have different different ideas about their business. Their creativity comes out in different ways in their life, and they don't want to draw, they don't want to create in that way, and they don't want to paint. I don't really draw that much. I actually have been more lately, and so I'm excited about the fact that I'm getting myself to draw and do charcoals again. Not something that I really was planning to do for any purpose except for to practice. And then I started realizing my charcoals are pretty awesome, so I'll probably be putting those up for sale as well. Why not, right? Why not share the work that you've done? And selling them is a really good way to do that. If you don't get them out on the market, then you're going to be giving them to family and friends, and then who's going to see them except for your family and friends? So my bet is you're more masterful than you know, and you can make a career out of this. And if that scares you too much, you could start even a part-time career out of it. And I'm very happy, you know, working as an artist, and it's not always easy. It's definitely not easy at all. Easy is not the word. I don't really work for things that are easy. Nobody works hard for things that are easy. And I'll tell you, it makes me a little crazy when I talk to people, other artists. We'll just, you know, I don't like to throw other artists under the bus, and nobody knows who I'm talking about, so that's fine. But one thing that makes me a little bit crazy is talking to another artist, and the first thing they say when I do oil paintings is, oh, I could never do that, that's too hard. Well, why wouldn't you do something that's hard? Like, if you're gonna live your life that way, like, then that's pretty dang boring. Sorry, but that's just the way it is. Not really sorry. Not sorry. Sorry, not sorry. What I'm saying is, do something hard. You know, that's going to be
what makes something new, something true and creative come. Nobody wants to be mediocre, as far as I know. If they do, then okay, but I don't want to hang out with them. So anyhow, all I'm saying is, if you're not doing oils because it's too hard, then freaking learn how to do it. If you're not doing them because you don't like the medium, I understand. I have mediums that I'm not super excited about, you know. But don't not do something because it's hard, you know. Just way too much of that. Way too much of that attitude of, I'm not going to do something because it's too hard. Or, I don't know. I mean, I do know. I know it drives me nuts. That's all. So what I'm doing here is just completely different than what I'm doing on the other portrait of him. So it's kind of fun. I have no desire to ever copy my own work. So that's just how I roll. Doesn't drive my soul at all. Doesn't drive my soul at all to copy. My own work or anybody else's. I like to learn from people, yes. But I did promise to share a video. I'm not totally sure how exciting this video is, but of me painting, and I'm probably not going to finish my painting in front of you guys right at the moment, because I will need to go run home and take a shower here pretty soon. What? That's how I get started a lot of times. Sometimes it depends on what I'm doing. All right. So, I think we're gonna put in more. I have some it's kind of a new color that I pulled up. I'm sure if it's all that exciting, but I thought I'd try it because it just looks like kind of fun to try. It's called Ground White, so it's like an off-white. So, I, you know, often mix titanium white with a lot of my work. So, that is not, This isn't a color I'm all that used to yet, and how it mixes with other colors, but it's fun. So wanted to try. See what it's about. I did buy it for a specific purpose. But not this painting. This is just practice, have fun painting. I really don't practice painting very often. I practice drawing. But I am doing a pretty huge piece right now and just like thinking through what I'm doing on his portrait, applying some action to it, I guess, in a way, is what I'm doing today. It's just because I'll go back and work in the studio today for a bit. Of course, I've been up since 4, and working on in the studio today, doing some business. This morning, and that's so ugly right there. So ugly. Let's go ahead and scrape that. This is not a good color to just put on your painting. It needs to be mixed, that's for sure. And so sometimes when I'm doing these, I really don't waste a whole lot of paint either. I just, if I scrape, I usually reuse a lot of it. But this is somehow sometimes how I do these multimedia pads. Yeah, I didn't bring yellow with me, and yellow is the color that I need for his shirt. So I don't think I will be doing his shirt with you guys right now. But I'm going to scrape his jacket and get a good start. And having that ready to have, I work on it a little more in the studio too as I look at his picture and actually have some lines to look at and follow because I'm seeing.